Hi everyone, so today's video I thought I'd introduce you to Lucille. As you can see, he's a corn snake. So this is new for me. I thought I'd just tell you about a little bit about Lucille. Lucille is a yearling corn snake. He's a Carolina hypo male. His name Lucille is from The Walking Dead, if anyone watches The Walking Dead. I've had him for about, how long have I had you? A few days now. Let's keep that there while he's not in it. He's at the moment in a 3 foot viv. He's about 1.5 feet in length, I think, pushing on 2. So once he gets a little bit bigger, he should go into a 4 foot, and then he'll be in a 5 foot when he's older, depending how big he gets, because they range from about 4 to 6 foot, but normally averaging about 4 or 5 foot. So let's move everything back. If you watched my updates video, you would know that I've been getting more wanting to get into reptiles, so I thought this is one of the best ways. I also have a leopard gecko in here, but the tank's dark because they don't need UVB lighting. But I do, she has got a heat mat and everything like that. But I'll get onto his tank trial, then I'll do hers. So this vivarium I got second hand for £50, including the heat lamp, heat mat, and I think that's all that came with it, yeah. So not with the heat mat, the heat mat's not on at the moment because at the moment I need to get a second thermostat for that, but at the moment the heat lamp is on. Sorry about that. It's a ceramic lamp with a guard, and we've got a UVB strip at the back. Always need a guard on heat lamps because they can climb up and burn themselves. It's safe for these, but he hasn't really climbed up too far. He only sticks to the ground. This is all linked up to a thermostat. It shows. So it's set to 30 degrees, which is the temperature it's great for corn snakes. The substrate we have is acid shavings. I might change it to something else. I'm kind of looking into doing a natural setup, like with eco earth and stuff like that. So over here we have a hide. We have the thermostat on the back, and we have the two plugs to fill with the heat mat and the thermostat. There's the little, what do you call this? That regulates temperature. And we also have this little cave. He can't fit in it. He can fit in it, but he doesn't really use it. Then there's the lamp, obviously. Then over here, we have a water dish. He does need to get a bigger dish soon because he can't completely sit in, which is important for shedding. We have a bit of bogwood here, which I think looks kind of cool. We have this, this is actually a hamster house, but he likes to go in it completely. And we've also got this bit of, it's not driftwood, some sort of driftwood thing. And we've got this plant, which I normally sit over the top, which it looks like kind of like a cave kind of looking thing. But yeah. That's him, and then I'll introduce you to Penelope. So this is Penelope. Sorry about the lighting, but she likes it dark, as it's her nighttime now. She is a normal leopard gecko. She's about 6 months old. She's a good sized tail at the moment. It still needs some growing to do, and she needs some fattening up, but I thought I'd show you her setup. Again, I'm going to apologise for lighting as I'm using a lamp to point it, but she lives in a 2 foot viv. When she gets adult size, she will be upgraded into 3 foot, so she'll most likely get his viv, and then he will get a 4 foot one. And I don't know what will go in here, maybe something else, we don't know yet. But I thought you'd give a tour of her vivarium. So this is a debatable thing. Yes, she has loose substrate. She will not get a blockage in her stomach because of eco earth. Eco earth is great, she does digest it, and I have seen it in her poo, and I have asked multiple leopard gecko breeders and leopard gecko owners that use it in the UK, and they say their leopard geckos have lived 10 years, 15 years on it. So just to point that out before anyone wants an argument, I don't fancy it. But over here we have her calci dish, which I put mealworms or waxworms, whatever she does get, in there, and she also does eat the calcium, which is good. She has a wooden log hide which has sphagnum moss in, which I dampen down every day to make sure she, when she's ready for shed, She can go in there, she can cool down, and she can shed properly. She's got a water dish here, which she has decided to kick some dirt in and some spiking moss in. We have a plant over there, which has fallen down. Over here, if I can get a good light on it, we have a bit of bog wood, which she can go underneath and sit on top of. And she's got another log hide, which is a hot hide. She has a thermometer there, with a heat mat, and then the thermostat is over here, and it's put at 30 degrees, but at the moment I've put it down a bit because at night time she does have to have a natural drop in temperature, so at the moment it's at 25 degrees Celsius.